Is Amazon deactivating your listings because they're priced too low or too high? Are you trying to fix this issue, but you cannot find the items in BQool? In this video, I will tell you everything you need to know about the delisted items and how to fix this issue. Keep watching. What's up, BQool family? My name is Marco, and I'm here to teach you how to optimize your BQool's repricer. We have received a lot of questions about the delisted items and how to fix the issue. So today, I want to take all this issue and this topic once and for all and explain how BQool handles it. So first of all, why it's happening? Well, Amazon have this safety measure on called potential pricing error that is designed to delist your item if they are priced too low or too high. As you can see in this example, this is the price alert that we received for a price of $1,000. It says that it's a potential high pricing error and it turned it into inactive. So when it's a high pricing error, it's because Amazon is checking the other seller's price and you might be probably higher than everyone else. But it's also checking other e-commerce platforms like eBay, Walmart, or Shopify. And if they have a lower price, then Amazon doesn't want to be higher than them, so it's gonna delist you. When it's about the low price, when it's a potential low pricing error, then it's usually more based on your costs. And Amazon knows that you are basically selling for a loss and they don't want this, so they deactivate it. So what can we do? What can we do to prevent this or at least decrease the chances for this to happen? There are three things to take care of. First of all, you can set min and max prices in Seller Central. As you can see, Amazon is letting us set some min price and max price in here in Seller Central. It is important to set these min and max prices on a wider range than the one in BQool. So if in BQool you have a minimum price of 10 and maximum price of 50, in here you can set a minimum price of 5 and a maximum price of 60. So you know that no matter how much BQool will gonna change your price, it's always gonna be between min and max in Seller Central. So this is very important. But what can we do on BQool side? On BQool side also, it's about min and max prices. So if we want to set proper min and max prices, we need to make sure that for the min price that we are calculating it based on your cost and the fees. So for example, in this example, what you can do is you can open the profit calculator, check all your expenses, and set, for example, a profit margin of 10%. So in this case, we know that you're not selling for a loss and probably Amazon will not gonna delist you. But the most important thing is the max price, because sometimes we notice our customer, they set very high, unreasonable max prices like $5,000, $1,000. This is a problem if the rule is gonna decide to price you at max price, because Amazon will definitely delist you. So try to set max prices with a reasonable number, usually based on the recommended retail price. It could be that price plus a bit of a percentage, just to make sure that that is the best case scenario for your sale, but still an acceptable number for Amazon and for the market. Another thing that you can check and make sure is your rule. In your rule, there are going to be settings that are going to price you on your min price or on your max price. So for example, in here, in a default rule, you can check which settings are using max price or using min price. For example, when you are the only seller on a listing, by default, the repricer is going to price you at max price. Or if the buy box is below your min price, you might have a setting that sets your price to your min price. Or if the buy box is above your max price, it might set you to max price. So if you don't want this to happen, just go to the repricing rule and change it to something else, something a bit maybe more conservative. If this already happened to your listings and now you're trying to fix it, you might have noticed that the listing have disappeared from the managed listing page. Actually, they didn't. It's just that they are on a different page. So let's see where. This is the managed listing, and what you can do, you can click on status and filter only by delisted. This will take you to a new page called the listed table. In here, you have a list of all the items that have been delisted. Some of them are not delisted because of a potential pricing error, but they're still here together with the others. In this particular case, why do we want to come here? Because we want to change our min and max prices and eventually also the rule. So for example, for the first ASIN, right now we have a very high max price of 500 and this is too high. So what we can do, we can change this to 50 and eventually change the rule to another rule that is maybe a bit less aggressive and save. Once we have done this, the listing is obviously still the listed, but now BQool have different min and maxes and more reasonable. So this takes us to the next stage. You can go on Seller Central again, make sure that you put min and max prices that are on a wider range, and then you can reactivate the listings. Once you do that, BQool is gonna start the repricing again by using the new min and max prices. So probably Amazon will not delist them again because your price is more reasonable. I hope this have helped you fix the issue and understand a bit more about the potential pricing error. If you have liked this video and you want to see our next episode, please subscribe to the channel. And also you can leave a comment and give us some suggestion about the next episodes. If you have any question, you just ask us and we're going to reply to you and maybe feature you in the next video.